6, 7, delivered by House Chaplain Dr. Margaret Crum.
Would you pray with me? Eternal God, we pause to orient ourselves to you in this moment, that we would acknowledge that by your grace, you set among us humble heroes who distinguish themselves in every clime and place with their selfless and noble acts of courage. Thank you for the life and legacy of Chief Warrant Officer Hershel Woody Williams, whose example of devotion to service beyond self was extraordinary. May this ceremony in this Hall of American Pride serve to honor him suitably for his conspicuous gallantry and intrepidity. The accounts of Chief Warrant Officer Williams' unyielding determination and courage clearly reflect an esprit de corps that ran deep within Woody's being. As the flag unfurled on Suribachi, Woody Williams, a true Marine, never lost his nerve as he fought for right and freedom, his honor clean, his purpose noble. So may our tribute prove worthy of the valor and grit so reminiscent of his time, the greatest generation. And may our lives be inspired to pick up the mantle to serve as Woody served, ever mindful, ever faithful to his fellow Marines, military families, and veterans who even today dedicate their lives to preserve the precious gift of freedom we each enjoy. Receive then this Marine, O God, into your keeping. May this good and faithful servant stand guard at heaven's gates, rewarded with your own well done. In the name of the one who is always faithful, we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Mitch McConnell, Republican Leader of the United States Senate.
It was October 5th, 1945, when President Harry Truman presented the Congressional Medal of Honor to 14 heroes, including the valiant patriot who now lies before us. In his remarks that day, President Truman said, "We fought a good fight. We've won two great victories. We're facing another fight, and we must win the victory in that." President Truman knew that America's work was not finished, even after winning the Second World War. And likewise, Corporal Woody Williams, even after demonstrating the stunning heroism that earned him our nation's very highest honor, knew that his own work was not finished either, that perhaps his greatest deeds still lay ahead. The thing that drew a farm boy from West Virginia to a lifetime of patriotic service could best be described as a gravitational pull. The Marine Corps' initial skepticism at Woody's short stature could not deter him. His stint with Western Union, delivering the painful news that created Gold Star families, could not dissuade him. And even his improbable safe return from dangerous combat couldn't convince him that he had actually done enough. Woody knew that true gratitude for our nation's service members ran even deeper than medals. He made giving back a lifelong mission. Giving back to his brothers in arms, giving back to generations of servicemen and women who followed in their footsteps, and especially giving back to the families of the fallen who'd never got to welcome their loved ones happily home. I was lucky enough to meet Woody and share a stage with his mission to honor and support Gold Star families unveiled a special memorial in Owensboro, Kentucky. By that point, he'd been giving back to his beloved country and those who defended it for 77 years. So needless to say, Woody's service leaves us a rich legacy. His valor in combat is enshrined aboard the USS Hershel Williams and at the Hershel Williams Armed Forces Reserve Center. His commitment to his fellow veterans inspires caregivers at the Woody Williams VA Medical Center. And his namesake foundation continues its work to honor the sacrifices of families left behind. Our nation was richly blessed by the life of Woody Williams, and we trust he now rests with his father, from whom all blessings flow.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Nancy Pelosi, Speaker of the United States House of Representatives.
As Speaker of the House, it is my solemn honor on behalf of the House of Representatives to pay tribute to Chief Warrant Officer 4, Hershel Woody Williams, an heroic American, a courageous defender of liberty, and the last surviving Medal of Honor recipient of World War II. The Congress offers our condolences to his daughter Tracy and Travy, his grandchildren and great-grandchildren, and his entire beloved family. Thank you for allowing our nation to join you in mourning this patriotic American here in this temple of American democracy. As the forces of tyranny threatened liberty around the world, Woody proudly enlisted in the Marines, eager to serve his country. At just 5'6", he was never the tallest Marine, at 135 pounds, never the biggest, yet he was a force of nature on the battlefield. At Iwo Jima, Woody marched through a hailstorm of gunfire, single-handedly destroying 7 enemy positions. In awarding Woody the Medal of Honor, President Truman called his unyielding determination and extraordinary heroism. Even after the stunning feat of bravery, his service was far from over. He devoted the rest of his life to helping veterans and Gold Star families and all families, always driven by his motto, "The cause is greater than I am." Today, we are joined by military leaders and Medal of Honor recipients. Let us salute them. Thank you for your presence here today, and that is a testament to the reverence with which Woody is held by generations of U.S. service members and veterans. Let us thank them for their service and their presence today. With Woody's passing, we have lost a deeply selfless American and a vital link to our nation's greatest generation. His story echoes the service of so many Americans who faced the horrors of war so that liberty might triumph over fascism. Many of them were just 17, 18, 19 years old. They summoned awe-inspiring courage, keeping the flame of democracy burning through our darkest hour. As Admiral Nimitz said of those who fought at Iwo Jima, uncommon valor was a common virtue. Many of us in Congress have traveled around the globe to honor heroism of our World War II veterans at Normandy and elsewhere. When I had the privilege of joining a ceremony to mark the 75th anniversary of the Battle of the Bulge, a veteran in his 90s shared his memories of that brutal fight. He spoke about the camaraderie among his brothers in arms, about the friends he lost. At the end of his speech, he made a simple request: pray for peace. Let us honor Woody and his compatriots by carrying on their legacy of leadership and service, by preserving the just peace for which they fought so freely. He feels so comfortable under that flag. What a combination. May he rest in peace. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President's own United States Marine Band Vocal and String Ensemble.
To me is calling, and
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the benediction, delivered by Senate Chaplain Dr. Barry C. Black.
Let us pray. Wonderful Lord, continue to walk and talk with us. Tell us that we belong to you. May the joy we share as we tarry in your presence transcend earthly treasures. We thank you for the life and legacy of Chief Warrant Officer Hershel Woody Williams. Lord, we praise you for providing us with someone who was an exemplary role model for courage, service, and freedom. Thank you for the beauty of his life, which brought light to darkness, joy to sadness, and hope to despair. Merciful God, support us all the day long, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is over and our work is done. Then, in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at last. We pray in your sovereign name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain at your seats until escorted to pay your respects by the Sergeants at Arms staff. Thank you.